I am Thomas William Samuels, born Thomas Oliver William Logan Samuels, to the parentage of Henry C. and Cora W. Samuels in Miami, Florida, February 27, 1934. Everybody knew everybody in the neighborhood. My mother never wanted me much to be up there on the corner with the kids. So when I would go up there, I often got a whipping because I would get so involved I didn't hear her calling. And she taught me a valuable lesson that I still apply to my prayer life. Whenever I pray, I expect an answer. And when I would tell her I didn't hear her, she would tell me I needed to stay close enough to hear when she called. So I've devoted that kind of thinking, even to this day, to prayer life, that I can be close enough to hear the Lord speak when he answers my prayer, when he answers my call.
I've had some good days. I've had some hills to climb. I've had some weary days. And some lonely nights. But when I look around, and I think things over, you know what? All of my good days outweigh my bad days. I won't complain. Sometimes the clouds hang low. I can hardly see the road. I ask the question, Lord. Lord, why so much pain? But he knows what's best for me. Although my weary eyes, they can't see. So I'll just say, thank you, Lord. I won't complain. God has been so good to me. Has he been good? He's been good to me. More than this whole world you could ever be. He's been so good to me. You know what he did? He dried all of my tears away. Turn my midnights into day. So I'll just say, thank you, Lord. I've been lied on, but thank you, Lord. I've been talked about, but thank you, Lord. I've been misunderstood, but thank you, Lord. You might be sick, body racking with pain, but thank you, Lord. The bills are due, don't know where the money coming from. But thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I won't. Hey, 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 hey. I
I won't complain.
Well, I graduated from high school in 1951 and went away to Bethune-Cookman College in Daytona Beach, Florida. Permit me to retrogress just a moment before I leave high school to talk about my best friend, Robert B. Ford, Jr. Bobby and I went to the movies together on Monday, and of course, the movies was where I first saw my wife. And when she turned 14, I went to her English teacher. They had a talent program in their English class on Fridays. And I went and asked if I could sing on her birthday when she turned 14 in 1948. And the lady gave me permission to do it. And I sang a song that was sort of centered around a town called Juanita in Mexico. Well, that's where we sort of got together, and it's been on ever since. This is my 64th wedding year, and 2018 with 64 years. We married at age 20, but from 14 to 20, we were just sort of dating, courting, whatever you called it. Wasn't what people do now. Nobody was going to nobody's house to stay overnight and things like that. But we did stay in touch. We dated, we wrote letters that we passed from hand to hand. And then when I went away to college from Bethune-Cookman College back to Miami where she was, until she came to Bethune-Cookman. And she wasn't there but 2 months before we were married. We were both 20 years old. She had had a job between high school and college. I went directly to college. And so we married. We are the parents of 4 children, 2 sons and 2 daughters. Janita, our oldest daughter. Synovia, our second child. Henry, our oldest son, and Thomas II, our 4th child. We are the grandparents of 5. Synovia has 3 children. Henry has 2 children. We have 8 biological grandchildren and 1 foster these are great-grandchildren. We have 8 biological great-grandchildren and 1 foster great-grandchild for a total of 9. Henry is the grandfather of 6 of those 9. Synovia is the grandmother of 2. We live in Charlotte, North Carolina, where we moved in 1973 because of my ministerial assignment. I came here to pastor a church in Charlotte in 1973. It is now 2018, 44 years already. And I became a Primitive Baptist president of the national body of Primitive Baptists here in America in 1965. I was elected to the presidency of the National Primitive Baptist Convention, USA, in Savannah, Georgia. It's been quite an interesting life. I was a pastor of 4 churches. My first church was in Mount Dora, Florida, very small congregation. At age 23, I was ordained in 1957 in Gainesville, Florida, at the Shady Grove Primitive Baptist Church. And I assumed the pastorate of Mount Dora Church in 1957. That was in February. Later in 1957, I was called to the Mount Zion Church at Eustis, Florida. I hadn't been ordained at that point to either one, but I was preaching at those churches, and I was finally installed as pastor of both of them later that year. I stayed at Mount Dora until 1959, when I was called to the Zion Hill Church at Lakeland, Florida, where the Lord blessed me to be the pastor to lead in the relocation of that church. I was able to lead in the building of a brand new worship facility and a dining area attached to the church there. I left Lakeland in 1973 at the Mount Moriah Church in Charlotte, North Carolina. And this is the church from which I retired on the 28th of February in 2006 at age 72. So it's been quite an interesting life story. This is a summary. This does not have a lot of detail in it. But there is a good chance that I'll get an opportunity to continue this discussion in the future.
I want y'all to help us do it. Lift your hands in this atmosphere and say, I am grateful.
I am grateful for the things
that you have done. Look at them and tell them, yes, I'm grateful. The victories that we've won. Tell them I could go on and on.
About your works.
Because I'm grateful, so grateful to praise you, Lord. Lift your hands and say, flowing from my heart.